Hello students, today we will discuss the introduction to mythology. So in the period 1900 to 1975, many experiments took place. So due to these experimental approaches, the study of animal behavior developed during the 20th century. The four experimental approaches which developed were: first was ethology, second is behavioral ecology, third sociobiology, and fourth is the comparative psychology and physiology. Ethology, the word ethology originates from ethos, which is a Greek word. Ethology is the systematic study of function and evolution of behavior in its natural habitat. And this field originally developed in Europe. It is tended to study animals in its natural environment and concerned with four areas of inquiry: what is the causation, what leads to its development, what is the evolution, and how does it function. Early ethologists gathered data by field observation. They also conducted experiments, often with nature providing the variables. So in the nascent stage, ethology and its experiment were conducted in nature. That is, the behavior was studied when the ethologist visited the place where the behavior was being displayed by the organism. But later, ethologists have manipulated the variables for their own purpose by using animal models. So they developed models which can be studied in labs, playing recordings of animal vocalization or altering the habitat, then it can be done. So the behavior was studied inside the laboratories and external stimulus were given. So the important thing is the shift from nature to the labs. Modern ethologists also conduct many experiments in the laboratory where they can test the predictions under closely controlled population. And usually they display the results. But sometimes the scientists, they compare the laboratory observation with observation of free-ranging animals in the wild, to check whether this behavior is observed in the wild also or not. The study of ethology is so important that in 1973, Nobel Prize for Physiology was awarded to three pioneering zoologists, Carl von Frisch, Corinne Lorenz, and Nico Tinbergen. All these three scientists, they played a very important role in the development of ethology. The very important fact that these three scientists emphasized was that behavioral traits can be measured and they have evolutionary history. You can see these are the photographs of these three Nobel laureates of ethologists: Carl von Frisch, Conrad Lorenz, and Nicholas Tinbergen. And they got the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine of 1973. What did they observe? See, Conrad Lorenz, then you can see Frisch and Tinbergen. These are some images which are depicting what work they have done. In the first image, you can see Conrad Lorenz and many ducklings walking behind him. In the second image, you can see a stickleback fish and its behavior. And in the last photo, you can see Frisch work on bee language. So the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine 1973 was awarded jointly to Carl von Frisch, Conrad Lorenz, and Nicholas Tinbergen for their discoveries concerning. See, this was the topic for which they were awarded the Nobel Prize: organization and elicitation of individuals and social behavior patterns. So ethology is a very nascent science. It's a newly developed science, and we will see what work was done by Conrad Lorenz. See, Lorenz in 1935 investigated the mechanism of imprinting, where some species of animal form an attachment to the first large moving object they meet. Conrad Lorenz said that after birth, the organism becomes attached to the first large moving object. So it can be the parent. If they see the parent first, they will become attached to the parent first. So this process suggests that attachment is innate and programmed genetically. Then he did an experiment. He took large class of goose eggs, suppose there were 100 eggs, and kept them until they were about to hatch. When they reached to the hatching stage, what he did, out of the 100 eggs, we have supposed that they were 100 eggs, half of the eggs, 50 eggs were placed under a goose mother who laid the eggs, and 50 eggs Lorenz kept in an incubator. And he made sure that the 50 eggs which he kept in the incubator, when they will hatch, the first thing those goslings will see will be him. So the first moving object the goslings will see will be Lorenz itself. And the 50 eggs which he gave to the, which he kept for incubation near the goose mother were going to see goose mother as the first moving object. So he was trying to see whether imprinting naturally occurs. In the next step, he observed that the naturally hatched baby gosling followed their mother, because according to the concept of imprinting, Conrad Lorenz said the first moving object they see. So the 50 eggs which he kept under the goose mother saw the goose mother as the first moving object. So they used to follow her. While the incubator hatched used to follow Lorenz. You can see in the picture, Conrad Lorenz is moving, and the goose eggs which hatched and saw Lorenz as the first moving object, the goose are moving behind Conrad Lorenz. So to ensure imprinting had occurred, Lorenz put all the gooseling together under an upturned box and allowed them to mix. When the box was removed, the two groups separated to go to their respective mother, half to the goose and half to the Lorenz. So this was a very important experiment done by Conrad Lorenz. Then we move to Nicholas Sternberger. He is known for his studies of stimulus response processes in the wasp, fishes and gulls. I shared a diagram with you in the previous slide, in which we have seen stickleback, the behavior of stickleback. So he did stimulus response processes in the wasp, fishes and gulls. He shared the Nobel Prize in Medicine 97 for work on the organization and the cause of social and individual patterns of behavior in animals. During 1936, Tinbergen and Lorenz both began constructing a theoretical framework for the study of ethology, which was then a fledgling field. They hypothesized that instinct, as opposed to simply being a response to environmental factor, arise from an animal's impulses. This idea is expressed by the concept of a fixed action pattern, a repeated distinct set of movements or behaviors, which Tinbergen and Lorenz believed all animals have. A fixed action pattern is triggered by something in the animal's environment. In some species of gull, for instance, hungry chicks will peck at a decoy with a red spot on its bill, a characteristic of the gulls. Tinbergen showed that in some animals, learned behavior is critical for survival. The oyster catcher, for instance, has to learn which object to peck at for food by watching its mother. Tinbergen and Lorenz also demonstrated that animal behavior can be a result of contradictory impulses, and that a conflict between drives may produce a reaction that is strangely unsuited to the stimuli. For example, an animal defending its territory against a formidable attacker, caught between the impulses to fight or flee, may begin grooming or eating. In 1951, book The Study of Instinct is credited with bringing the study of ethology to many English readers. The book summarized some of the newest insight into the way signaling behavior is created over the course of evolution. Then the third Nobel laureate, Carl von Frisch, he initial use of experimental methods in behavior. He was the first to do that, studied senses of bees, and he identified the bee communication, translated meaning of the waggle dance, length and number of the waggles is equal to distance, angle of waggle run to vertical of hive is equal to angle of food from the sun. So it was a very important discovery. So bee language was discovered by Carl von Frisch.